Hi y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. Today you are seeing the start of my garden. So if you look back here, I don't know if you guys remember, but if you've been following me for any length of time, you know my whole yard was covered with trees and we got them cut down in 2022. It was 19 trees back here. And so our plan is to make a food vegetable and I would say flower garden, and we're gonna plant some fruit trees as well. So we're gonna try to utilize this space as much as possible, but I wanted to share with you what this first bed is, and it looks pretty pitiful in comparison to what it will look like whenever we have the finished product. But this bed is the first bed, and my friend inspired it because when my dog Champ died in 2020, she promised she was going to buy me some peonies, and we kept putting it off, and we have 4 peony plants here in the garden. This is the first one. So this one's a pink peony. This one's white. It was needing a little bit of water, so we put some water on it. It'll perk up in a minute. And then this one right here is another pink one, and this one is a white one. So peony is my absolute favorite flower. And when we were at the garden center just trying to get the soil right for this particular bed, the landscaping guy told us that we should plant herbs so that it would keep the bugs away. So the first herb plant we have right here is rosemary. That probably looks very familiar to most of you. This right here is not an herb plant. This is ghost peppers. You guys know my husband loves hot food, so we have ghost peppers here. And then we have some mint. We have 2 different types of mint. And I don't know if you knew this, because I surely didn't know this, but if you plant mint right in the ground, it kind of takes over everything. So she told me, well, the owner lady, she told me to plant it in a pot. So I have two types. This one right here is chocolate mint, and this is regular spearmint. So I'll be looking forward to putting that in my juices and in my smoothies. Let's see. Right here is a geranium plant, but it is a citronella variety, and of course that keeps bugs away. Then I have like one of my favorite plants, and this is lavender. Lavender is absolutely a magnificent plant. It's in some of my herbal blends. It's in the womb healing clay, and I believe it's in my womb healing tea. So I can't wait to have that come up with the aroma from that particular plant. So let me come around here. One day I'll get to the point where I'm growing and drying my own herbs. And these are all organic plants, by the way. This right here, I can't remember the name of it, but it's sort of like a spreading flower. I just wanted some flowers around. I love flowers. That's like my favorite thing. Of course, this is a petunia. These look so pretty in the summer for me. And then I have another rosemary bush, because you can never get enough rosemary. So many things you could do with rosemary. Rosemary is one of the herbs that is in my Grow Your Hair tea, but I like to cook with it. I like to use it as to put it in my oils, in my butters and stuff that I put on my body. And I can't remember the name of this plant, but my husband wanted it, so okay, there you have it. He has it. And in the front of my house, I have like 4 or 5 garden beds that have flowers in them, and I maybe will show you those at a later date. You can comment below if you want to see my flower garden. But yeah, one day this is going, at least this side of my yard is going to be fruits and vegetables and flowers. All right, thanks so much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. I'll talk to y'all later. Take care.